So I have a kind of a confession to make, guys. I just could not come up with a video topic for this month. I really thought about it. I thought like maybe Skinamarink, but that just feels so played out. Then I considered, I don't know, something something the role of class in animated sitcoms. I don't know, is that anything? Is that engaging? But at the end of the day, nothing would come to me. So this month's video is going to be something totally different, and based on the timestamp, I'm assuming you've probably noticed, and I'm assuming that by the end of the time I finish this video, it's going to be a fairly quick one. Today, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite content creators, famous Hollywood designer Marcus Pork. Senior.
And all I've got to offer is sensitivity, intelligence, and charm.
Marcus Pork is 32 years old. He worked as a wedding planner for over a decade before leaving that career to chase his true passion, fashion design.
My name is Marcus Pork, and I'm 32 years old. I'm a famous Hollywood fashion designer. I love clothes so much that I wear them every day. But I haven't always been this way. For 10 years, I was wedding planner. Planning a new wedding every day. This job was not glamorous. I would always work so hard planning a wedding, but sometimes the bride and the groom wouldn't show up, and I would have the wedding alone for no money. This was the straw to break my camel back. Last year, I quit the weddings, and now creating designs that everybody loves.
In fact, he's so passionate about fashion that he's maintained his single status over the years to chase that dream. He's much too busy working on his fashion career to be tied down by the ladies. It says so on his website. In fact, his website says a lot of things and answers a lot of very good questions, but please don't yell. Anyway, Marcus Pork uploaded his first TikTok on November 12th, 2021.
My name is Marcus Pork, and I'm 32 years old. I'm up and coming famous Hollywood designer. Please buy my clothes. The clothes are coming soon, and the clothes will be safe. Thank you.
In which he clearly states his intent to become a famous Hollywood fashion designer, hashtag famous Marcus. From there, the lore grew and became, you know what, let's just talk about it. So the first thing I want to talk about, and one of the most fascinating things to me about Marcus Pork, is his family. Normally I wouldn't bring up a content creator's family, but he does. So Marcus Pork is Marcus Pork Sr. He has stated that there is a Marcus Pork Jr. He also mentioned that he has a daughter named Sasha, but he cannot tell us about the rest of his children. Stating, I cannot tell you about the others.
I have a daughter called Sasha. I cannot yet tell you about others. Hashtag famous Marcus.
What does this mean? Do we think Marcus Pork Jr. and Sasha exist? Because I kind of don't. I think, and we'll get into this in a second, I think Sasha may have been invented to give credibility to his feminism. There's a whole section here for the feminism. Also, I'm just gonna say it, I wrote like half a script for this. 75% of this is gonna be just me talking. But we'll get to the feminism thing. I think Sasha may have been constructed to really push Marcus Pork's feminist agenda. So we know he's single. We know there's a Marcus Pork Jr. and a daughter named Sasha, and apparently other kids he cannot tell us about right now. Also, he's 32. But what about the focus of his social media presence? What about his fashion career? Oh boy. So according to Marcus, he grew up in California and worked in the wedding industry for 10 years. That is very impressive if he is in fact 32 years old. But you know what? I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. He quit the wedding industry after he realized he wasn't in love with it and was really in love with fashion, which he grew up surrounded by in California. This is the most believable part of the Marcus Pork character. I'm gonna call it a character. He lists his fashion inspirations as Gucci, Nordstrom, and Jeremy Renner. As far as Jeremy Renner goes, Marcus has stated that he simply likes the way he dresses, specifically his leather jackets, which are a favorite of Mr. Pork's. Since his fashion career kicked off, I love this man. Since his fashion career really took off with TikTok, he's actually invented quite a few new articles of clothing. A big highlight was the Shat, which is a shirt and a hat. Here's a picture.
I was experimenting in the studio and came up with this. It's a hat and shirt combination. What should it be called?
Genius. The Wikipedia page shirt, which is a shirt with a mock-up of what his Wikipedia page will one day look like printed on it. And that kind of served a dual purpose of getting the word out about Marcus and how he really needs a Wikipedia page if he really wants to succeed, right? There's the relatable coffee shirt, which has a picture, or a self-portrait, rather, of Marcus holding a cup of coffee, and it says, "Don't wake me up until I'm having the coffee." Very relatable. And then to kind of bring us into his work in feminism, there is the Free Bleed Friday shirt. About the Free Bleed Friday shirt, Marcus has stated, "Free bleed is brave, and be feminist, love the bleed." Marcus is, as I've mentioned, a stout feminist, as you can tell based on the creation of the Free Bleed Fridays shirt.
I love Free Bleed.
He has astutely observed that women are everywhere. We are surrounded by them, so we should treat them with respect. And in an interview with Paste Magazine, he stated, "I became a feminist a long time ago. That's because I've always loved women. You know, I wanted to be on their side." And in one of his feminism videos on TikTok, usually hashtagged feminist Marcus, verbally, like he says out loud, hashtag feminist Marcus. But it was in one of these feminism videos that we were first introduced to Sasha, which is why I believe she may be a figment. But, like, this is all well and good, but who is he really, right? Like, he's not 32, is he? And who is directing these TikToks? Because personally, I think the comedic timing of these videos is too good for this guy to be orchestrating the whole thing. So before I made this video, I kind of went down a rabbit hole of trying to get to the root of Marcus Pork and find out, you know, who's holding the camera, who's Sasha, who is he really? And what I found was nothing, hence the length of this video. I did find this very interesting article, which I quoted earlier from Paste Magazine, and they gave us like a little bit of insight, but this man is not breaking character. When asked if his TikTok fame has gone to his head at all, he stated, "Becoming TikTok famous, it made me very popular. It made me very recognizable. People started recognizing me, but I'm still the same nice person, and I'm not a diva at all." He also said that he will stop in the street to take pictures with fans, so that's very nice, but that doesn't really tell us anything, right? He then goes on to explain why he joined TikTok in the first place, which he says reasoning was, "I liked it. I wanted to be famous, and I think that was the beginning of everything else." Very true, very true. You can now follow him on Instagram. You can get a cameo from him. I might try to get a cameo to put in this video. We'll see how expensive it is. I haven't checked.
"Hello, Ellen. Congratulations on 10 years of making videos and being YouTube famous. Maybe one day you can be famous, and 33 like me. My advice is to find a magazine to write an article about you. Hope all your dreams come true. Hashtag famous Ellen."
Yeah, it's, there you go. But again, not telling us all that much about Marcus as a person. When confronted about the fact that he does not look to be 32 years old, and when the interviewer brought up the fact that some TikTokers have accused him of lying about his age, he states, "Yes, I am 32. Otherwise, I wouldn't say I'm 32. Fair enough. Fair enough.
"I am 32. How can I be any older? Old people know nothing about fashion. I'm a very sharp dresser."
He also goes on to explain that you do not have to be a famous Hollywood movie star to wear his clothes, despite him being a famous Hollywood fashion designer. He says, "My clothes are very fashionable. Everybody can wear them. Children can wear them. Grown-up people can wear them. It's something that's for everyone." He also has mentioned in his TikToks many times that you can wear them even if you are ugly, even if you are gay, even if you are trans. Really, really inclusive with his fashion designs. So this guy is like a real mystery, right? When I first discovered him, I was convinced that he was somehow a Nathan Fielder bit. But then, you know, the rehearsal came out and I was like, Nathan Fielder probably doesn't have time to be doing also Marcus Pork. Or maybe it's Marcus Pork Jr. who's pulling the strings here. Whoever it is, the NDA has to be just airtight because I can't find anything. And like I said, the comedic timing of these videos is just very catered to social media and like social media humor. Like for Halloween, he dressed as a pumpkin and it cuts, the TikTok cuts to him and it says Marcus Pumpkin, and it cuts before the word comes out, which is just like a masterclass in like TikTok humor, right? Like that kind of like awkward timing.
"I do not believe in ghosts or a goblin ghoul. The only thing I believe in is myself."
Marcus Pumpkin.
And stuff like that. So someone has to be doing this. And I don't think it's Marcus. I'm not even sure if his name is Marcus. Marcus Pork. But also, kind of on the other hand, even if someone is pulling the strings behind the scenes, I don't see it as like a malicious thing, because Marcus is like, he's very sweet. Like, there's something very endearing about him and his inclusivity, his sense of humor. There's something very, very genuine behind this facade. If it is a facade, like I said, it's really hard to tell. I was really hoping to fill this video with like a big reveal of like, this is who Marcus Pork is. Part of me does really hope that this guy really exists as Marcus Pork, as that character, and just genuinely loves fashion, is inventing the Shat, which is, that's, come on, he didn't come up with that. Putting his Wikipedia page on shirts and making sweatpants that say free bleed Friday on the butt. All while kind of preaching this inclusive message and really welcoming anyone who comments into his community. So Marcus, if you're watching this, I'm gonna tag you. So I really hope Marcus Pork shows up here. Keep doing what you're doing. I support your fashion career. I love your fashion designs. I would love to get a hat, which reminds me, you can purchase some of his designs on his website, which I'll link in the description. Go support Marcus. I'm probably gonna get myself a hat. And yeah, I mean, hashtag famous Marcus, hashtag free bleed Friday, hashtag feminist Marcus. Hi guys, I know this was like a weird, short, mostly unscripted little thing, but work has just been insane recently, and I'm in a show right now, and I actually have lines in this show. Ugh. Gross, I know. So I just really haven't had the capacity to really sit down and write a real video. And the Rizzo video really did take a lot out of me. So thank you for clicking on this. Just relaxing a little bit. I'm so serious. Go support Marcus Pork. I'm considering slipping a cameo in here. Yeah. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a comment, give it a like. If you'd like to see more, consider subscribing. I promise most of my other videos are a little bit more high effort than this. If you want to support the channel, you can become a patron or buy some of my own Hollywood fashion designs. Links to both of those are in the link tree down below. Patrons get fun perks like Discord access, credit at the end of the video, etc. And if you didn't like the video, why do you have to be such a downer? All right, bye.